Are you all right, my friend? Come on. Let's go home.
Your Grace, you came for me. I waited for you so long, but you finally came.
I'm not who you think.
Clive.
Yes. Pray forgive my long delay.
It's nothing, Your Grace. I prayed to the Founder that you would come. And at long last, he answered. Will we be returning to the castle then? There is still a place for me in the kitchens?
No, my friend. We will not be returning to the castle, not yet. I'm on a very important expedition. One which may take some time. Could you wait for me in Eastpool until my journey is complete? I will come back for you then. I promise.
Of course, Your Grace. For you, I would gladly wait until my dying day.
Thank you, both of you. You've been most kind. The memory of serving the late Archduke was his one light in the darkness. And now that light burns a little more brightly. It's nothing but a fantasy, of course. But it's better than the truth of the matter. A damn sight better. The blight is on our doorstep. Our harvests are failing. The people are leaving in droves. If it weren't for Lady Hannah selling half her worldly goods to provide for the few of us who stayed behind, we would long since have starved. We want to keep the bearers safe here, we really do. But unless a miracle happens, we won't be able to spare a crust of bread to share between them soon enough.
Is it really that bad?
So bad, I even petitioned the Imperial Garrison to take them. But when they found out where they'd come from, they damn near spat in our faces. Ducal dogs, they called them. Enemies of the Empire.
I know a man named Cid, who would gladly give a home to any bearer in need of one. Leave this with me. As soon as I return from Phoenix Gate, I'll speak with him.
Thank you, my lord. Will you be passing through Eastpool on your way back? I should very much like to speak with you again, if you have the time, regarding the future of the village, and what might be done for Lady Hannah, after all she's done for us.
Yes, of course. I'll be back anon.
Fare you well, my lord, my lady. I wish you a safe journey.
Deadlands are aptly named.
I didn't realize they were this close.
No wonder their crops are failing. The blight. Leaching the ether from the soil. And when the last drop is drained, their fields will turn to this. No plants. No animals. No life.
And no monsters. I suppose that's one small mercy.
What's this? Another relic of the fallen. We won't be able to use any magic here.
Another thing to worry about. As if the absence of ether didn't cause enough problems.
Take away the lad's life force, and problems are all that's left.
I can hardly imagine what this place used to look like before the Blight took it.
I remember. It was beautiful. There it is. Phoenix Gate. Where it all went wrong.
Come on, Clive. It's time to discover the truth. It's almost as if time had stood still.
I suppose no one had any cause to return here. No. It's just as I left it. Let's have a look around. Could I have done this?
Could anyone? What is it, Torgal? Clive!
That's him. He's the only one who can tell me what happened. I have to know! Where is he?
Nowhere to be seen.
Damn it! He's like a bloody eel.
What is this place anyway? Some sort of shrine?
Oh, sorry. You've never been here before.
This is the Hall of the Gate.
The Gate?
It's a relic of the Fallen. Only the Phoenix's dominant can open it.
Hence the castle's name. This was where Joshua was supposed to...
Yes. He would have stepped through this door the next morning and listened to the words of our ancestors.
Would you have gone with him?
No. The apodotry is holy ground. None but the dominant may enter. I and the other shields would have stood guard here and prayed for my brother's safe return. Where the hell did he go?
Perhaps he went inside.
He couldn't have. He'd need the power of the Phoenix. Thank you, Joshua.
Are you sure about this?
Nevermore.
Another gate. Let's see if this one opens.
Hardly call it a ruin. It's perfect. Like it was built yesterday.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
Jill? Trouble.
this. This must be what the fallen ruins were like before they fell.
And leave.
Stay down!
Would Joshua have had to run this gauntlet too?
No. At least not that I ever heard about. I imagine the Phoenix would receive a warmer welcome.
Here we go again. Where will we end up this time?
Surrounded by contraptions hell-bent on murdering us, I expect. Could the Hooded Man really have taken this path?
We won't know until we've followed it all the way to the end. Come on, let's keep looking.
Ugh!
like this.
Seems the feeling's mutual. Get him, boy!
Ugh!
it's done.
What are these creatures? And why do they keep attacking us?
They're probably asking themselves the same thing. We're the ones trespassing here. They're just protecting their home. Jill, look.
Is that some kind of mural?
It's worth a closer look, whatever it is.
Thank you.
inside then.
This place holds even more secrets than we thought. Something.
So, it isn't a dead end after all.
Apparently not. And look what's in it. How old do you suppose this is? 1,000 years? More?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like it before. Who is that in the middle, do you think? Some sort of god.
You're him. The second dominant of fire. Who are you?
Joshua chose me to be his shield. He gave me his blessing and asked me to keep him safe. I should have protected him that day. It was my duty. Joshua died. I killed him.
And I blamed another for what I did. To spare myself the guilt. I feared that by accepting it, I would lose what little was left of me. So I ran. From everything.
And now? Are you ready to accept the truth?
I am. I know it won't be easy, but it's what I must do. So that Joshua's soul can finally rest in peace.
us on.
Come, Ifrit. Show me who you truly are.
Yeah!
From you. Together. It's time to find out who we are. Once and for all. Show yourself, you're free.
truth of it now. You are not Ifrit. I am.
Clive, are you all right?
Jill. It's nothing. I'll be fine. No more chasing shadows. The hooded man isn't here. We should go.
Clive, are you sure you're all right? Whatever it is, you can tell me.
I had a hard enough time telling myself. I awakened as a dominant of fire, right here in this castle. And I've been running from it ever since. But now I know for certain who I really am. The second Icon of Fire, who killed my brother and burned this castle to the ground, was me. Ifrit.
Clive.
I took so many lives that night, and destroyed so many more, including yours. And I must atone for the crimes I've committed. But not before I learn the whole truth. How can a second Icon of Fire even exist? And why was I chosen as its dominant? Who is the hooded man who brought us here? And what does he want? I need to know. And since I'm still breathing, I might as well make myself useful.
We'll find your answers together. I want to learn the truth too. There'll be time enough for atonement when we're done.
I was hoping you'd say that. I don't think I could do this without you. You never were one to hide from the truth, even when we were young. And you haven't changed a bit.
You're wrong. I have changed. But I don't want to be that person anymore. The things she did were unforgivable. And yet, they're what brought us back together.
Thank you, Jill.
If he is here, then the disturbance I felt at the care must have been confounded. The hour is later than I thought.
Who delivered the coffin said, he said Sid paid him.
I let you run amok with the rest of your rats, and this is how you repay me? Find out where he is. I'll crush him, flay him, rip out his heart, him and all his filthy brood, and send every last one of them to out. No!
Yes, yes, my lord.
So, what next?
We return to East. I promised the mayor I'd talk to him again. About Lady Hannah, amongst other things. Though she may be loath to leave, I can't help thinking she'd be safe. For with Sid too.
All right. We should arrange an introduction then. What is it?
Nothing good, I'll wager. Come on.
Escape us, did you, Branded? You were born a slave, and you're still one! Kill all the Ducal dogs!
Ducal dogs?
We're innocent people!
Stay down! sheltered them.
By Empress Annabella's command!
My mother ordered this. Why?
Why?
Sorry, Lady Anna. You deserved so much better. All of these people did. Better than my mother.
Too late!
Gav!
Clive!
Acting on the orders of the Duchess, eh?
We knew East Pole was harbouring bearers. Thought they were safe enough hidden up here, but someone must have let slip.
If they'd have only come to us sooner, none of this would have had to happen.
Fuck!
My mother always did despise bearers. The way father embraced them when the other nations spat on them as slaves. The way an accident of birth gave them a power that others lacked.
But why kill everyone? They meant no harm. They just wanted to be free.
This world judges that a crime punishable by death. Which is why we're going to change it. Gav, we want to help.
Thought you'd got your own stuff to be getting on with.
We do. But it can wait.
In that case, we should head back and tell Cid you've had a change of heart. He was always on it yet to join us.
All right.
And we'd best be quick. Last I heard, he was planning another excursion.
What about the villagers?
Oi! Can I leave you's lot to take care of things here?
Of course. We'll make sure they get a proper burial.
Thank you. All of you.
When you're ready, then.
Now, rats, lead me to your nest. Lord Kutgar's message for your leader, if only he knew where to send it.
Sid Sola, then. We have a lot to discuss.